good morning, a good early morning. It is, well, for me anyway, it's about 7 o'clock. About 7 o'clock. And we are heading to Troy, Ohio. We're on 30 right now, going to hit 75 south. About an hour and 40 minutes away from a place called Clopay. It is a garage door manufacturer we picked up at before. Headed down there to probably drop the trailer off. And then I don't know for sure. They have, so these, the garage doors are floor loaded and it takes a long time for them to actually load the thing. I picked up here before, I'm expecting a minimum of 10 hours to get loaded, so I'm trying to decide if I'm going to drop the trailer and leave and either, so they'll let you stay there while your trailer's getting loaded, but then you're just kind of, you're parked in a little spot they have for bobtails and you're just sitting there with zero to do, and I don't know for sure what's going to determine. So I booked this one through a different broker than I've ever done. I've never pulled a load for them before. And they said this won't be ready until like 9 a.m. tomorrow. Which, if that's the case, I think I am going to go get a hotel room for today just to have somewhere to hang out. I really don't want to sit at the facility all day and all night and then leave out in the morning. I don't know if that's what I'll end up doing, but right now that's not what I want to do. We're picking up this load and it's going to Washington State. It doesn't drop till Monday. Today's Wednesday. The trailer probably won't be ready until tomorrow, but I don't want to take off in the middle of the night, although we'll see when we get there, because I didn't get a whole lot of sleep last night. I'm tired. Maybe. Just maybe. If they say this is going to take 10 or 12 hours, I'll probably just stay there and go to bed, and when I get up and it's ready, I will start driving at night. But we'll just see. We'll just see. I don't have anything really well planned out right now. All I know is I'm going to get down there and it takes a long time to load. Fog over the fields looks very cool right now. So yeah, we're going to get down 30, go to 75. This place is right off of 75 by Troy. It was like pulling teeth out of a Wolverine to get a decent load yesterday. I dropped off in Northeast Ohio, which I know freight rates out of like Northeast Ohio, Northwest Pennsylvania really aren't that good. So I dropped and then I came over to Northwest Ohio where freight rates are usually pretty darn good. And man, they were not good. They were horrible. It took me all day yesterday to get a decent load. I watched this load, this same load, from three different brokers on DAT all day. And there were three brokers that had this load posted, and they all three had different rates, when none of them were very good. But as the day progressed with one of the brokers, which is who I'm pulling this for now, the price kept increasing. So finally, once it hit what to me is a good rate, I called them, offered them more money, obviously, or offered to do it, but for more money, and settled on a it's a good rate, because these are light loads, and went ahead and booked that. It sucks because going to Washington State, the freight there is, it's not good. It's terrible. But when you can get a load right now anywhere that's a good rate to go anywhere, you just, I'll deal with it when I get there because, you know, I used to be able to go from Ohio over to Illinois, like Chicago area and stuff, like $1,500, $1,800 for 280, 300 miles, which, you know, pretty good. Now, you can't get over there for, I mean, there's $600, $700, $800. It's like, no. Heavy stuff, too, 44, 45,000 pounds. Nah, I don't want to do that. I really don't like doing anything that isn't at least $1,000. And a good rate at $1,000, you know what I mean? Like 300 miles for $1,000, especially right now, I'll do that. But there was nothing even near that. It was terrible. The market right now is terrible. And it's been terrible for a while, but I kind of thought, not thought, but like every time I come over here to like Ohio, Indiana, Illinois, Wisconsin, Michigan, those states seem to have so like such a high volume of freight that the rates stayed okay. But no, and I don't know if it's just because it's August, and I have heard through the grapevine that carriers are renegotiating all their deals and stuff with the shippers. That affects the spot market. I don't know why. But, I mean, there were loads yesterday. I saw the boards posted for 40 cents a mile. That's insane. And I don't know if it was just a typo or what, but there were several of them from J.B. Hunt for like 40 cents a mile. 90 cents a mile. No one can. Hotshots can't make money at 90 cents a mile. So, I don't know. I'm happy to get this load that I got. It's a nice long haul with a big payday at the end. So, thank goodness. But once we get to Washington, we'll see. I'd like to find something from Washington, either down into California or back to Colorado or Salt Lake, something like that. Freight rates for dry van out west just suck all the time, but you got to get the money when and where you can, so we're going to head to Washington State, which will be a cool drive. I went out there quite a bit last year delivering furniture to different stores and stuff, but I haven't been out there in a long time. It's a pretty drive. Go through like North Dakota and Montana, pretty states. So, and there's a lot less truck traffic in those states. The Dakotas have gorgeous waysides where you can stop and do your tents and stuff, and it's nice. So, yeah, we're gonna get up here. Like I said, I still got about an hour and a half before I'm at my pickup point. I don't have to be there till 8 o'clock or 9 o'clock, so we'll get there early, get this dropped, and kind of figure out what we're gonna do for the day. But yeah, we're gonna get down there and see what goes on today. It's gonna be a long, boring day. I'll decide what I'm going to do once I get down there. So we'll talk to you guys in a bit. All right, good morning. If I look like crap, it's because I feel like crap. I've been here for, what time is it? 23 hours, which is awesome. 23 hours to get loaded, which when I booked it, the guy said 24. But then when I got here, because I've picked up at this place a few times before, I asked them if it would really take 24, and the guy was like, well, something would have to go seriously wrong for it to take 24 hours. I guess it only took 23, but that's crazy, man. I don't know. And then I went to bed. No one called me saying it was done. I just got up and walked in this morning, which I guess I shouldn't complain about that either, because I got some good sleep, but this took too long. Good thing this is a really good paying load, but good Lord. Now we got to go hunt our trailer down in this yard, then scale. Got to give our weight to the scale guy, or the security guy. And get going, this is a long ride, 2,069 miles to our first stop. Then we have another. Let's see where they put this trailer. Find it. What sucks is we have to come back down here and turn around. The scales kind of tricky to get on here, and it's narrow, so that's always fun. I look like crap. Oh, there's the trailer, I do believe, right there, though. Yep, there it is. Scale will give me just my gross weight, which is all this place wants to know. It won't give me each axle, you know, so I have to stop and do that too, depending on what our gross weight even is. I gotta get the fuck out of here and get going. This took way too long. It's a lot earlier in the morning than I wanted to start. Or not earlier, sorry. A lot later in the morning than I wanted to start. I need a shower. The side of my beard's all flat. The side of my face, I slept on. I need diesel, I need DEF. I need food. I need a shower.
In yep. 1/4 mile, turn right on Barnhart Road, then take the first right.
GPS in here gets a little confused. There's the scale there. See, I mean, to have it out of the way, they have it tucked really far to the right. And when we come back out of here, have to take this turn really far, really wide. I'm going to back into here and use that to turn around. That's just what we're going to do. You know, yesterday when I asked this guy how long it would take, he said I was number two in the order of priority. I'd hate to see what number like three and four are. Put gigantic boulders and shit in the way. It's like they want you to hit it. This scale just gives us our gross weight. All right, let's go check out and get the F out of here.